update on the problems at Lincoln Park High School. Yet another interim administrator brought in to lead the school has been removed and is under investigation.
WGN's Marcella Raymond is live outside Lincoln Park High School with the latest developments. Marcella.
Hi, Mike and Joe. Students say that chaos and high tensions are causing their school to have an atmosphere of being very strained and possibly dangerous.
It's just like really, really hard for us to actually get work done.
Hard because there are distractions like this. A fight that happened this afternoon that brought Chicago police and fire to the school. At least one student was injured.
It was like a few people fighting and then security just like tackled everyone.
Several parents came to pick up their kids concerned about their safety.
I feel more safe about that, you know.
Shortly before the fight, hundreds of students staged a sit-in, flooding the school hallways.
Until we get what we want, school is cancer!
Their signs read, "Reformation of the Administration," and "Why Lie to Us?" There were several posters asking if their school is safe. The protests spilled outside.
I want to be heard.
Giovanni Munoz says this is him on video when an interim school administrator allegedly grabbed his face. She was let go. Students say she's the fourth administrator at Lincoln Park in a month.
To be honest, I'm kind of sad to represent this school right now. It's really disappointing.
Tension in the school began after CPS started investigating what they called, quote, system-wide misconduct among staff and the sports department. Assistant Principal Michelle Brumfield and Principal John Thewitt were fired.
When Thewitt and Brumfield were at our school, the hallways would always be super happy and you could feel the energy that everyone was excited to be at school. Now everyone's heads are down.
I just want to bring like LP back to what it was.
So Chicago Public Schools has not responded to my request repeatedly for a comment today. I'm live in Lincoln Park. Marcella Raymond, WGN News.